Okay, so I'm out and about, just doing a local afternoon walk, and before I tell you where I am, I did check the weather and it's just started raining, so I hope it stops, otherwise this could be the shortest walk I've ever done. So yeah, so all being well, if this rain disappears, I've parked up in Outlane and I'm just going to walk around Jagger Green, Holywell Green. Now, I used to call it Holywell, but apparently it's called Holywell, and there is something going back in medieval times about a miracle happening, or a miraculous well that gave miracle water or something. Anyway, all being well, I'll find that and we'll have a look, and I've got a bit of history about it on here. And then a little bit around Stainland and maybe West Vale as well. And then see how it goes. So, catch you in a bit. Okay, so there's a nice view of Stainland there. I'll just try and zoom in. And just try and catch Stainland Church in the picture. I'm hoping that's the spire there. Yeah, that looks like it. Okay, so I've just passed through Jagger Green and I'm heading for Holywell Green. First stop is Shaw Park, but originally I think it was somebody's garden, so somebody wealthy, the Shaw family, once again, as most wealthy families in Yorkshire, built on textiles. Now, there used to be a big house there as well called Brooklyn's House, but like quite a lot of country homes, it's sort of not, well, it isn't there, it's not there anymore. So, but the gatehouse is there, or the entrance lodge, or whatever they'd call them, and the park's there, and it's got the follies that the Shaw family had built, so they're quite interesting. So we'll have a look at that. So yeah, I'll update you when we're nearer to Shaw Park. Okay, just seeing these three metal gate posts. Look like they're made of cast iron. They've obviously been there a long time. I just wonder, what are they? They haven't been put here just for decoration. They've been there. They must have had an original use way back when. I mean, at the moment, I haven't a clue what they are. Quite fascinating. Right, we'll be approaching Shaw Park any minute now. Okay, well, I'm in Shaw Park now at Holywell Green. Now I understand this used to be a garden for possibly for Brooklyn's house, belonging to the Shaw family. And I mentioned earlier there was some follies. Now check this out for a folly. See, it's absolutely brilliant. It's look at that. Looks like the entrance to a Norman castle. Okay, so here's another one. Not sure what it's meant to be. And there's something just around the corner as well. Don't know if I can see it from here. Yeah, just something there. Okay, so I think in its day it would have been something you could walk up to and actually go inside. So there's a pathway that goes up to it. But the park is owned by the council now, so they've locked it off, probably so it doesn't get ruined and vandalised. Sensibly. Okay, well this walkway over the pond bit here has been sealed off, probably because it's a bit dangerous now. Bit overgrown now as well. So this is where it leads to. Okay, so this wall with the balustrade on top will have been part of the original Brooklands house. This gives you an idea of what a substantial garden it must have been. Well, this is it. This is the healing well. How far back in time it goes, you know, the time where it originated, it's hard to find out. It seems to be a mystery all round. It could go back before the 1600s. So I'll give it a Google search and see what I can find out. Okay, so there it is. That looks like Brooklyn's Lodge. Gateway to the former country mansion, Brooklyn's House. Okay, so there's a nice church building. It does it. United Reformed. Okay, so what's all that about? You've got Baptist, Methodist, Nonconformist, and now you've got this United Reformed. It's just a strange history of always subdividing and arguing over the Bible. It's a bit funny, really. But nevertheless, like all of the churches, they probably mean well. United Reformed, it sounds like a few decided to stop arguing and join forces. Anyway, it's a nice building and it still looks like it's in use as a church, which is it makes a change. Seeing that many churches abandoned, religion and belief seems to have gone out of the window. So there's one still up and running there. Okay, so a lot of traffic noise, which I don't particularly like, but I'm heading for West Vale now and we'll have a look at what there is in West Vale. Okay, so just there in the distance, there's a disused railway line that goes from Holywell Green to West Vale. Okay, so you'll just seen the video clip of that old derelict mill. Now these mill buildings, they're absolutely fantastic, like cathedrals in their own right. I couldn't make much comment back there because of the traffic, so I've just found a couple of back lanes to walk along just to get away from the traffic noise, because I'm in the middle of West Vale now. And this road noise just doesn't stop. There's no break in between. So, just going to pass a couple of more interesting buildings that are no longer used for their original purpose. But nevertheless, the architecture is fabulous and it's still there. And they're probably listed just to protect the aesthetics of them. Although this one looks abandoned. Ah, it is abandoned and it's for sale. Oh, it's been for sale a long time, I think. Okay, I'll catch you there. Okay, so this one's the old Civic Hall. Next door to the Civic Hall is a former Baptist chapel. Well, what a spectacular building. This is a former Church of England church, St. John the Evangelist. Wow, it goes back to 1882 and was last used in 1982, so they got 100 years out of it, but the architecture is absolutely spectacular. Former church next door looks even older. North Dean Chapel of Rest, something to look into. Can you see there where there would have been a bell? To ring out. signal to the congregants, come in, you're about to be giving a sermon. These look like former mill buildings here, which, like I said before, are cathedrals in their own right, with incredible towers. Okay, so I was just passing and I thought it's well worth a looking at this. This is Clay House. This is a 17th century building. Now it's owned by the council now, but it was originally the house of the Clay family, going back to the 17th century. Sure what they were involved with, but possibly cloth. But look at this, this just looks the part, just looks the 17th century era. I think they call it Jacobean architecture. Okay, so I'm just round the back of Clay House. This is the official start of the Calderdale Way. Wow, look at this, it's just spectacular. Just seen this cast iron work, one at this side, looks like some kind of a bridge from Victorian days or something, possibly with a railway line have run through here in the past, I don't know. Okay, so I'm on the Calderdale Way footpath and it should lead me to a former chapel. Well, the chapel's still there, but I think it's been, or has been converted for residential. It's a primitive Methodist chapel. But the architecture will still be there. Okay, so this is the former Greetland primitive Methodist chapel. Now I don't know why, what the primitive part relates to, but that's what they call it. But yeah, it's been renovated. Wow, look at this, it looks fantastic. Wow, must be a lot of work involved with this. Okay, so I'm at the back or the side of what I think is St. Thomas's Church at Greetland. It's a Church of England parish church. We'll soon see. Okay, so I'm just making my way back up to Outland now. I'm just still in Greetland, but I'm sort of climbing out of it or walking out of it, and we'll be passing through, I think it's called Halifax Bradley Golf Course, and then back to Holywell. Well, back to Holywell, and then from Holywell back to where I've parked up at Outland. Now, on this route, I noticed in the past when I've walked through here, there was a mill and a derelict mill unused. I can see from here loads of scaffolding on it. So as I get nearer, we'll take a look, and it's actually being put back into use. Wow, it's looked quite a big undertaking. So this is what it looks like from here. Okay, so I'm just making my way to Holywell, and there's the view of St. I think it's St. Andrew's Church, Church of England, and it's got this lovely, I don't know what you call them, cupolas for the roof that houses the clock and the tower. We'll get a closer view of it. I think this is one of them mechanics institutes, but I'm not sure. It's a phenomenal looking building though, just look at that. at that balcony on it as well. Okay, so I'm just making my way back on Car Hall Lane, and just noticed this. Looks like some kind of drinking facility for some animals. Not seen one like this before. Very long row of them there. Okay, so as I was saying, my battery just suddenly died on me there, so I've just changed the batteries in the camera. Drinking fountain for horses by the look of it, although I don't know why one was kind of enclosed inside those concrete slabs. So yeah, a good historian would know, but I'm just learning as I go along. So yeah, so this pass will bring me back to the start. So I think I'm just about done now, and it's just getting dusk here. So if this has made it onto YouTube as a video, and you've been watching and found something interesting, then very good. And thanks for watching, and all being well, I'll catch you on another walk. Cheers.